and to improve the imaging experience for our consumers, we have recently announced a strategic partnership with Zeiss. Zeiss, as you know, is a distinguished player and a pioneer in the field of professional and mobile imaging. As part of this partnership, Zeiss imaging technology will be enjoyed by many more consumers. Together, we will co-engineer an imaging system for Vivo's premium smartphones, starting with the upcoming Vivo X60 series. Vivo and Zeiss share the same goals. We have an allied focus on premium technology and cutting-edge design. With joint development and co-engineering of optical components with Zeiss, we are confident that we will enjoy several great years of cooperation, thus providing consumers worldwide with a more appealing, easier to use, and more professional mobile photography experience. I would now like to introduce my colleague, Keshav Chugh. Keshav looks after the camera effect tuning and localization for India and other markets. Over to you, Keshav.
Thank you so much, Nipun. Hi everyone, I'm so glad to be here. I'm the product manager for image effects at the Image Cognition Product Center at Vivo, handling the camera effect tuning and localization for India and other overseas markets. Vivo is a consumer-oriented brand in everything we do. The core pursuit of Vivo Imaging is to create a pleasant imaging experience for consumers. How do we integrate imaging product functions, effects, operations, as well as factors like smoothness and stability to form user experiences? How do we make sure these experiences meet user expectations and are pleasant? These are the most important questions we seek to answer at Vivo Imaging. Through a lot of consumer research and discussions with the academic community, we found that the images mean two things to consumers. Firstly, images record and reproduce the objective world. They represent and reproduce our rational self and show our relationship with the world. Secondly, images show our subjective world. They reflect our inner emotions, our understanding, and expectations of ourselves and the world. Keywords to remember here are objective and subjective world, to reproduce and also to transcend. We sum these up as reproduce what the eyes see and transcend what the eyes see. However, neither is easy to do. For mobile phones, this means that from optics, platforms to algorithms, every factor has to be outstanding. At Vivo, for every generation of our products, the process always begins with consumer research. Over the past 3 years, we have met tens of thousands of consumers spanning the length and breadth of India, covering 300 plus districts in 26 states. During this time, we carried out about 200 ethnographic studies, more than 1,000 in-depth interviews, focus group discussions, and countless consumer tests to understand different aspects of consumer lifestyle and behavior. This involved talking to consumers across diverse cultures, age groups, socioeconomic class, and varied occupations. This has enabled us to develop a holistic understanding of Indian smartphone consumers. However, such understanding is just raw material that cannot be used directly for product development. For instance, we understand that consumer wants to have good colors, but what is good? It's extremely subjective. Is it richer, lighter, warmer, or cooler? This is where our cognition team comes in. Professional photographers and photo retouching experts from the team use their understanding and transform information from this research into products. After distilling such key insights from our extensive consumer research, we have identified a few focus areas. These are colors, night HDR, portrait, sports, zoom, and image stabilization. Since 2017, we have established 7 imaging R&D centers around the world in global hubs where talent and technical resources are concentrated. To summarize, it is not that one person or one team or one country is responsible for the camera. It is a result of collective work undertaken by hundreds of people across locations that are responsible for capturing the most important moments of life in a blink of an eye and preserve them forever. Thank you for having me here, and I look forward to meeting you all in person when the situation permits.
We also received a tremendous response from all of you when we asked you to share questions on Vivo's camera thinking. I will now be asking questions on your behalf. Let's see what the image experts have to say. In this session, I will also be joined by Win Go, the image product manager at our R&D center in Shenzhen, China. Are we planning any new camera innovations to be launched in 2021?
Of course. Both the IMX 598 and the GN1 only represent the beginning of Vivo's R&D efforts in photosensors. We are constantly pursuing important research areas with our partners. Today, I present to you a new technology that will have a significant impact on photosensor performance in the future. As mentioned earlier, color filter array, or CFA, is very important in a photosensor. In order to improve photosensitivity, CFA technology evolved from BEAR, called BEAR, to RYYB. But their limitations are still obvious. So, what's the next step? The answer is RGBW. RGBW is the new CFA arrangement, which groups the three primary colors of RGB into RWWR, GWWG, and BWWB. This brings a significant leap in photosensitivity and solves the problems of color cast that is common in the RYYB area. RGBW has the same 4-in-1 features of the quad bare filter. It leads to both a large pixel area and a high total pixel value. Okay, I'm sure you want to know the real difference RGBW makes. Well, as the new W filter is a transparent filter, covering the entire visible light spectrum, it increases photosensitivity of each W pixel, far better than the sub-pixels in the RGB mode, increasing the overall sensitivity to 160%. The first Vivo phone with RGBW sensor will be mass-produced in the second half of this year. It will bring a new level of performance and image quality.
So many details behind a single picture. Amazing. We know it is not just hardware that matters. So my next question is now about software. I want to know, what is the software wizardry that goes behind making this industry-leading hardware even more magical? Can you please give us some more details?
In smartphone photography, hardware upgrades are important, but algorithms are also critical. Our R&D center in Hangzhou has created excellent night photography algorithms, helping us fulfill the promise of reproduce and transcend what the eyes see. Let's talk about the self-adaptive noise reduction model first. We all know that photosensors have complicated noise issues, particularly in challenging light environments. No matter what noise reduction method you use, the overlap of color noise, thermal noise, and brightness noise remains a big headache. By analyzing noise on various levels of luminance and dynamic ranges, and the influence of circuit wiring design, we came up with an adaptive noise reduction model that combines static noise calibration and real-time dynamic noise estimation. And we tested each type of photosensor using more than 100 units of each to ensure that the noise model is accurate and reliable. Let the images speak for themselves. This is a night photo with clear contrast and detail. Let's zoom in. You can see that the picture is very clean. Detail of the rocks, buildings, and water reflections are very well preserved. We often say that we should keep our feet down on Earth while looking at up the stars. The starry sky inspires big ideas and romantic feelings, yet it is not easy to be recorded on camera. A good opportunity may only come once in a lifetime, but once you capture it, it deserves to be remembered forever. Not too long ago, comet Neowise flew past Earth, which happens once in 6,800 years. It was a photo opportunity not to be missed. Astro mode is how we fulfill our promise to help users inject emotions into images. What you are looking at now is comet Neowise captured by photographers using the X50 series. A lot of photographers have come up to me and asked how Astro Mode makes the stars and ground clear while making moving clouds, airplanes and comets look dynamic. Well, the most important thing when shooting the starry sky is focus. Experienced photographers will manually adjust focus instead of just focusing to infinity. Our engineers did the same thing. They made fine focus adjustments for different sensors and lens modules to ensure that every X50 phone can capture the stars clearly. In addition, most noise reduction algorithms will eliminate some stars from the image by mistake. To avoid this, we use big data learning to allow the algorithm to tell exactly which are the stars, which are dead pixels and noise, so you can get a beautiful sky full of stars. In addition, we use semantic segmentation to separate the starry sky and the ground to offset the blur caused by the rotation of the Earth. Through a starry sky alignment algorithm that is precise right to the pixel level,